Did you know that there may be as many as 150 different models of washing machines sold in the United States? U.S. washing machine manufacturers compete with other domestic producers, and they compete with foreign imports on top of that. Now, say you're an American washing machine producer, and you think the competition from abroad is just too stiff. What can you do? Well, you could ask the government to turn to a little-used trade remedy called a safeguard. In fact, that's exactly what happened in October of last year. A safeguard is a temporary restriction on imports of a specific product. The domestic industry asks for safeguard protection if the industry believes they are being seriously injured by imports. Safeguards are applied when the injury is a result of fairly traded imports. Safeguards are actually permitted by trade rules, but only under specific conditions. The action must be temporary. There must be evidence of serious injury to the domestic industry. The safeguard must be applied in a non-selective manner, and there must be adjustment by the affected industry. So in the short term, safeguards sound like they're good for domestic producers. But what about everybody else? Safeguards leave consumers with fewer options and often higher prices. This is one reason why safeguard measures are rarely used. Another reason is, in today's world of global supply chains, it's often hard to establish what a domestic industry actually is. Now, even when these safeguard measures have been put in place in the past, domestic producers don't have a great record of making the changes to better deal with foreign competition. So yes, a safeguard does provide a temporary cushion to a domestic industry which would otherwise be harmed by fair foreign competition. But in a world where consumers want high-quality products, wide selection, and low prices, there are enough downsides to slapping on a safeguard measure to make them a seldom-used tool in the trade toolkit.